the proportion z interval. For example, in 2004, ACT reported that in a sample of 1,650 randomly selected college freshmen, 1,221 of them returned to college the next year. Construct a 95% confidence interval for the true population proportion of freshmen who will return to college the next year. In order to construct a confidence interval for the true population proportion, we use the following formula. So we have p hat, which is the point estimate, plus or minus error, which is z sub alpha over 2, times the square root of p hat times q hat over n. And recall that q hat is equal to 1 minus p hat. So for this example, we have to determine p hat, and that's equal to x over n. And in a sample of 1,650 students, freshman students, 1,221 of them continued on the next year. So 1,221 is x, and 1,650 is n. And so that is equal to 0.74. So we're going to plug this number into the formula as well as the other information and simplify. Recall that the z sub alpha over 2 that corresponds to 95% confidence is 1.96. Q hat is 1 minus p hat, and so we obtain 0.26. For this next step, in the following steps, we're just going to simplify this into pieces. So I'm first going to simplify what's under the radical by taking 0.74 times 0.26, and that's 0.1924. Next, I'm going to divide what's under the radical. And so I obtain 0.0001166. In this next step, I'm going to take the square root of that value, and I obtain 0.0108. Now I'm going to multiply 1.96 by 0.0108, and I get 0.021. In order to get the lower bound, I'm going to take 0.74 minus 0.021, and I obtain 0.719. In order to get the upper bound, I'm going to take 0.74 plus 0.021, and I get 0.761. So this tells us that we are 95% confident that the true population proportion of freshmen who will return to college the next year is between 0.719 and 0.761.